What's poppin', pretty gang? It's your girl Maya, and I'm back with another video. So, y'all, as y'all can tell by this title, what am I doing today? I'm hotboxing my closet again, y'all. Hotboxing it again. Feel like I haven't gave y'all a hotbox video in a while. As you can tell by the title, I'm doing another hotbox video for y'all. And I'm going to be showing y'all and eating my favorite munchies. Yes, y'all, but my favorite munchies, I went to the store. Dollar General. First thing on my munchies list, because, like, who doesn't like these? I used to be in love with the green Takis, the green one, the dynamites. If you know the dynamite Takis, leave a comment down below, because when I tell you those shits was bust. But you are a real OG if you freaking eat these, like if you ate these before. I remember going to the basketball games, getting these all the time. I would buy like 5 of them. But these are the nerds, ropes, rainbows, like nerds, and then it's like some type of like candy inside of it. It's so good. I got me some Sour Patches because like Sour Patches is the best. Yes, my blue ones are the blue ones are my favorite ones. Blues are blue anything is really the best. Like blue is just anyway, the last chips I got, because like I really don't eat snacks like that, but these are the main snacks that I do eat when I'm hungry. And then I have my Pringles, the green Pringles. I either eat the green Pringles and the barbecue Pringles. I used to eat the freaking cheesy Pringles, but then like they just got nasty to me. So I only eat the green ones and the barbecue ones. So y'all, I'm done chatting. I haven't smoked all day. I haven't smoked in a minute. I haven't smoked in like 2 days, okay? I hope you enjoy this video. I'm about to spark up now. I'm about to stop talking. So people just want a vacuum, I'm doing my video, huh? Y'all, so we didn't have a backwood today. We didn't. We'll be at the second best thing, a blunt bill, y'all. If I had another one, but I gave some people some. But anyway, if I had another one, I would show y'all what they look like. They come in 3 in the pack. Really good to roll. New rolling tray. Got a little bit of weed on it, but I just want to show you how cute it was. I have a story time for y'all. The story time that I got for y'all is hilarious. Like, oh my god, this story time gets me every time. This video gets me every time. Okay, y'all, this is a story time of my first fight ever. I was in 6th grade. You know in 6th grade, we was all weird, okay? We was all weird. I was fat and had dreads. I'ma show y'all a picture of it. Look at it. Do I look like that? Yeah, no. So yeah, anyway, y'all, are y'all ready? I ain't even ready. I'ma start laughing. I already know I'll be cracking up in the video. All right, y'all. Let's get into it. So y'all, this was in 6th grade. I was friends with these 3 other girls. But listen. I'ma show y'all how we became friends. So in 6th grade, I met this one girl. We're gonna call her Pora, that's her name. So I met Pora in the math class when we were in 6th grade, and I was talking to somebody, and like I don't know where Pora just jumps in. It's just like, oh yeah, I've been there too. And I'm just like, well, okay, yeah. So like, because like I was just like, it just hit me out of the blue because she just came out of nowhere. But that's how we started being friends. We had that one class together and we were talking every day. So it was school dance coming up. School dance coming up. She was friends with this other girl. We're gonna call her Lulu, right? So Lulu was already friends with Sephora. So that's how I became friends with Lulu, because we would all hang out with each other, right? So listen, our little friend group, like diversity. It was so like cute. Like I just loved it. So me and Poro were like brown skin. Lulu was Spanish, and I have to get to the other girl. We gonna call her Ren. Ren was white. One day we're at the dance, right? We don't know Ren at all. We don't know her at all, listen. So we're at the dance, right? We're all dancing and stuff like that. And so like after the dance, me, Poro, and Lulu were going all to Poro's house. And so we met Ren inside the dance. So we were all chilling together. We were getting all cool and stuff like that. So we told Ren, we was like, okay, we'll see you later. She was like, oh, where y'all going? I was like, we're all about to go to Poro's house. She's like, well, can I come? So Poro is so hilarious. She looked at me and she was like, and I was like, just say yes. And then she was like, yeah, you can come. She just came over out. And after that, we all started being close friends, right? So we were friends for a couple months now. But how the whole thing started was because we all used to play fight. And we all play fight it because we really low-key wanted just to beat Ren up by y'all. We were, please don't think of me a type of way. I was a kid. I would have slapped myself in the face, or I probably would have beat my little ass if I found, like, if, yeah, I don't do that. I don't accept that. So we all just really play fight because like Ren had like a smart mouth. Like she had a smart mouth. So like that's like really like pissed me off a little bit. But she kept saying like, oh, she could beat me up and stuff like that. So Poro already fought her before in the room. So because we always used to play fight in the room, but we never took it serious. Like we were just cool. We used to record and stuff like that. We used to laugh. It was hilarious. So freaking after Poro fought her, I fought her, right? So next, like maybe a week later, I'm at school and stuff like that, and people coming to me is like, Jemaya, Ren said she beat you up. I'm like, what? Like, huh? When did she beat me up? Like, I was so confused. Like, I was like, I know this bitch ain't telling people that she beat me up. And then the fact that people would believe, y'all, listen, y'all gonna see me. Y'all gonna see how I looked. And then y'all gonna see how skinny that little girl is. Y'all think that little girl, you know, she maybe was taller than me, but like, height don't matter. Anyway, y'all looks a little bit ashy. So yeah, I went up to Ren. And, you know, I went in front of her and stuff. I don't really remember what I said, but, you know, I know the main thing I said was, why are you telling people you beat me up? And then it led to, do you want to fight? And, like, do you want to fight in real life? And then Ren's like, she's in front of everybody and stuff like that. So she's like, yeah, like, she's trying to, like, yeah, I want to fight you and stuff like that. I was like, all right, we're going to plan a day and we're going to fight. That's how you know I was a kid. We had to plan a fight. If you don't fight then and there, if you want to fight the person, then you don't really want to fight. Like, if you really want to fight that person, like, if you're like, ooh, I want to be her. Like, ooh, when you see that person, you won't want to, you know, ooh. But that's how you know I was a kid. I was like, yeah, let's plan a fight. So we planned the fight. The fight happened in like 2 weeks. Like, we planned this. Like, we was like, all right, not this week, but next week we're gonna fight in the bathroom after practice. Cause I used to be a volleyball player, and then I guess the volleyball season went over. Me and her was on the volleyball team together too. No, she didn't make it.
And
anyway, she had dance class, and I wasn't in no type of class stuff. I missed the bus on purpose. My house wasn't too far and stuff. So my friend who actually lived in the neighborhood with me, she actually stayed with me so she can record the fight. So she stayed after school with me, and we met at the bathroom. And yeah,
this happen?
Is it on?
Yes. Okay. It's recording. Dad Jake about to fight her.
Ready?
It about to be going down for real.
Ready?
Go, spread.
Wait. Guys, stop. Ooh, stop. Oh my gosh. Shut up.
I am dead. I had to go rewatch the fight. I did not mean to slam that girl's head in the sink. I did not.
If I could prevent that whole thing, I would. I promise you. Like, I am a whole changed, new, different person. I wouldn't dare do that to somebody. Back to the story. Yeah, I didn't mean to do that girl like that. I didn't mean to. But like, after the fight, and so the reason why I turned off the camera, y'all, okay. The reason why I turned the camera off is because if you get in the background and this little girl is like, oh my gosh, I gotta go tell somebody, or I'm about to tell something like that. And then she got the teacher that was right outside the bathroom. And she brought the teacher. She was saying, oh my god, these girls out there fighting. You can hear it in the video. I'm gonna replay it so y'all can hear.
Guys, stop!
Ooh, stop! So you can hear it in the video, she's saying it. And then like, that's why I'm saying, oh my gosh, like, what was this snitch? Like, you should stay your ass where you was at. Not in my bubble. Not, you should have stayed in practice. Didn't you see, y'all see she had a uniform on? You should stay where you was at, okay? Anyway, so yeah, I beat her ass and then, y'all, that video went viral. If you had Musical.ly, yo, it went viral Musical.ly. Because you remember Musical.ly was like the Snapchat, Instagram, all that. I posted on Musical.ly that fight. Everybody had to fight. Like, I don't know how everybody got the fight, but everybody had to fight. And then everybody had to fight. And then that's when we never got caught. We never got caught. We got caught 3 months after the fight. And me and the girl became friends again. Like, I don't know how we became friends again, y'all. I'm gonna just say we became friends again. Yeah. We became friends again. And the principal finally seen it on social media because, like, again, how viral it was. My principal found out about the fight. So he calls us in and stuff. He talks about it. We're like, we're friends now. That was so old ago. That was like, I don't even know how long ago that fight was. So I'm going to say that was like 3 months ago. And he was like, okay, I'm not going to suspend you or nothing like that, but I am going to call your parents. And then I was like, dang, like, bro, like, why? We're not going to get suspended or anything like that. There's no point in calling my parents. So he calls my mom and she grounded me. Mind you, oh, it was around December when they found out. So yeah, she grounded me for the whole month. No Christmas. I didn't get nothing on one of my list. I didn't get nothing on the list. I had no Christmas that year. My other family still gave me stuff. I didn't get stuff from her. Like, other people gave me stuff, but she didn't give me nothing. Cause she was like, you're grounded. And I really wanted the laptop that year. And she didn't give it to me. But guess what? My daddy got it for me instead the next freaking week. So yeah, that's how I fought. That was my first fight. That was a crazy fight. That was crazy. I feel really bad for that. But shoot, me and the girlfriend, we were friends, but I think she lived in Texas. Yeah. That's the last time I seen her. On like a TikTok. She was in Texas. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this video because I enjoyed making this video. This video was hilarious, if I don't say so myself. So make sure you leave a big thumbs up. Make sure you leave a comment down below. Make sure you turn on that post notification bell. And if you're not subscribed, why aren't, like, subscribe already? You watching me? So subscribe. So guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video and I'm out. I'll see you in the next video.